Hey, I'm Lee Keen, and this is my Extreme Flight 110 Yak. Extreme Flight's a company right out here in Atlanta. They make planes in all various sizes. They make them bigger than this, all the way down to something smaller with a 48-inch wingspan. It's got a 10-horsepower DA120 engine on it. It's a twin cylinder. It runs on 93 octane and a little bit of oil mix. And, you know, you pile the batteries in there. You got a bunch of different servos and stuff. I had this built for me, but you can also build it yourself. This is my third day, you know, at the field with it, and really happy with it. Flies good. The bigger they are, the easier they are to fly, but the bigger the crash is too when it goes down. You know, a lot of fun out here at the GMA field right north of Atlanta.
What is, like, I'll say, like, a plane, let me catch it here, the plane out there, what is a, you know, typical plane? I suppose that's like a typical plane there. What are those things run?
Yeah,
if you was going to buy one.
So this is, that's actually a, you know, Extreme Flight also. That's a 48-inch wingspan, and that's, you know, bang for the buck as far as what it's capable of and what it can do and how good it flies, and for cost of it is the best kind of deal out there. So that airframe's only about $170, and that's one of the nicest flying 48-inch planes that you can buy. And then the electronics and everything, the battery's about, you know, maybe like $60-$70, and then you got some more electronics that end up being about $200-$250 total for everything. But if you wreck that, you can pull all the electronics out, get a new airframe for $170, and you're back in the air. So that's kind of the beauty of it. You know, when you do damage, mostly it's just the airframe. So you can repair them easily for a lot cheaper, or just buy a new airframe, have a brand new plane.
Say 250, you're talking about the plane, batteries, I guess,
all the
remote too,
batteries, servos.
Somebody could go out and spend about $250 and get something like that.
Yeah, you can find an Extreme Flight 48-inch plane online used for $250 all day long, and I mean, you know, it's been flown a couple of times, but it still fly really good. So, and then it goes up from there. The airframe, this airframe alone, just the you know, the wood and everything, is about $1,100. The engine runs about that too, so it starts adding up quickly. But again, you know, if I have a incident with this, I can buy a wing or something. If I hurt the wing, I can just buy a wing on Extreme Flight's website. So
covered in something, or is that solid wood,
yeah,
or is there a frame and
there's a
veneer on it?
And maybe a little bit of plywood frame underneath, and it's similar to a real plane. And then there's what we call Duracoat or Ultracoat, which is a really tight, kind of thin, it's kind of plasticky, but actually you give it heat and it'll actually shrink it up. So this was put on kind of loose and then heated, you know, the blue and red and the white, all you see was heated up and it kind of shrank on. It's got a little bit of glue on the back of it that reacts when it gets warm, so it kind of glues itself.
tightens itself up. So, you know, it's kind of almost like a drum or something.
Wow, it is.
So the same kind of deal. Then there's some foam right here to give the circle. And then there's a little bit of fiberglass and stuff built in the plane. You know, you got some fiberglass for the front cowl that you can kind of see behind there. And you can see the framework in here. Carbon fiber also is a common material to use for some of these planes. The prop and the landing gear is carbon.
What's something like this weigh? 100 pounds?
No, I think this plane weighs about 25 pounds.
25, really? That's all?
Yeah, the lightness is the key. The lighter, the better for these aerobatic planes so you can do tricks. And
I don't know how you got here. Do you have to, like, take the wings off or something to transport this
off,
thing? They do? They pop off?
The elevator, it pops off the same as a wing. There's a big carbon fiber tube. You can see it right in there. So this carbon fiber tube runs to about here on each side, on each wing. And that really gives the strength of it. And then you just slide the wing over the top of it because the wing itself is very light. And also there's a carbon fiber tube for the back that runs about from here to here. And that's where the strength is. That's actually a Yak from Extreme Flight 2. A Yak is a Russian aerobatic plane. And you can see the graphics are very similar. Almost got a crash on camera.
That's what I'm here. That's what I'm here for. Ooh, look at that. Sweet. You had that up there for what, about 15 minutes or something? It must take.
Yeah, the fly time is about. I have a timer on the controller. The fly time's about. It could probably be 15 minutes. I have set to 10 minutes, but I have a bit of gas left over too. So you could get solid 15 minutes out of it, depending on how you flew it.
Now that's big enough to put a payload in there. So could you put another gas tank in there and keep it up in the air longer?
I got. Yeah. Stick that thing next to it. I got
it's the exact same thing, just smaller.
I have two tanks. I actually bought two tanks for it, but it only needs one. I mean, 10, 15 minutes is really all you want to do, all you want to fly. You're not trying to do 30 minutes. So you can see those are both the same planes. They're both based off the Yak. All these planes are based off, you know, real aerobatic planes. So most common is the Extra 300, but there's many of them. So, and the Yak is a really popular plane to use for RC flying, just because it always flies really good in a bit smaller form with how round the cowl is. There's a lot of ones that are squared off, but they're all actually really awesome planes.
Uh, what's the range on these things before you?
As far as you can see.
Really?
So yeah, if you the controllers will go as far as you can see the plane. So.
Well, that makes sense, but they'll go farther.
Yeah, I mean they'll keep going. There's a you can do FPV, which is you fly from point of view, so you actually have a computer screen set up, and then you'll have a camera on the plane, and then you actually look at the computer screen. There's a radio signal going to the plane, getting the live feed from the plane. So you'll have a guy out here, and he'll be sitting up underneath the shed over there with a computer screen and a controller, and then you'll look out. You know, there's a plane way off in the distance flying around.
Wow.
You run over and look, and you know he's actually flying the plane as if he was inside of it. So there's some setups that people do with those that go for, you know, miles. And there's so many different, the thing about this hobby is there's so many different things that you can do. You can do FPV, you can do, you know, scale flying, you can do the tricks and the 3D flying. You know, some guys are just really into building the planes and how, you know, how it looks and how scale it is. Other guys are, you know, the most powerful. There's guys who all they want to do is be the fastest. So there's always something new. So whenever, you know, you get bored of doing 3D flying, you can go do scale and build, you know, World War II, you know, warbirds and stuff. It's just as much fun. This hobby just escalates so quickly. You can start out, you know, with a little plane that costs, you know, $150 ready to fly. That flies great, and then end up, you know, something with this.
What is a plane like this? What's that run?
So this airframe is around $1,000. The engine is a little bit over $1,000.
The plane's $1,000. The engine is another $1,000.
Yep. And then the electronics and batteries and all the wires and fuel tanks and exhaust and all the little stuff probably adds up to probably another $1,000, $1,500. So this plane is, you know, $3,000, $3,500. In the air, which is not cheap.
Safe to assume you're a single guy then.
So yeah, well, yeah, I have a girlfriend, but she's you know, she understands it because I'm always, you know, I've always had hobbies and playing with toys and stuff like that. So.
Cool. I think I got it, man.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks.
Happy trails.